In this video, we take a look at the importance of network security. When we connect together computing devices in a LAN, allow them to share data, and then subsequently connect them to the wider internet, they become vulnerable to attack or misuse. There are many, many potential threats to a network. A few of them include malware, brute force, data interception and theft, and the concept of social engineering. So this makes protecting any network a high priority. We're going to go over a few of these concepts now briefly, but we cover some of them in a lot more detail when we look at our videos under the topic of issues and impact. So first of all, malware. In this situation, files may be deleted, they can become corrupt or even encrypted. The computers may end up crashing, rebooting spontaneously or slowing down without any logical or reasonable explanation. When a worm infects a computer, the internet connection may become slow as the worm searches online for other computers to infect. However, the worst symptoms of malware are often the ones that you do not see. Malware can be designed to simply record the keys that you press on your keyboard, for example, creating a text log that your computer then sends to a hacker periodically. The hacker then scans the text log, looking for passwords that he can use to access your email or bank accounts. It's worth noting that in a network situation, if a client becomes infected with malware, this is easily passed to the server and then to all other clients connected. Infections are able, therefore, to spread very quickly on networks. With a brute force attack, the hacker is trying to access corporate systems, potentially to steal data and gain access to sensitive information. With data interception, users and passwords are compromised, resulting in unauthorized access to systems. This can lead to disclosure and theft of corporate data. The photo shown here is an example of a packet sniffer, a device that can actually listen to the data that's being transferred between two points on the network. And by sniffing that data, the hacker is able to access usernames and passwords, which they can then use to log into the system in what seems like a legitimate way. Many system vulnerabilities are caused simply by people being careless. We refer to these as people being the weak point in the system. Here are some simple examples. People not installing operating system updates, not keeping anti-malware software up to date, not locking doors to computer rooms or not logging off, leaving printouts on desks with sensitive information, writing passwords down on sticky notes and then attaching them to computers, sharing passwords with colleagues, losing memory sticks and laptops, not applying security to wireless networks, and not encrypting data.